Hello everybody, we're still talking about the plotting in MATLAB, and this video is going to be very useful for people who are not very happy with coding. And I believe many people will not be happy with doing all these codings that we are doing and writing codes for anything that you want in the plot. And people, of course, who are used to working in or with Microsoft Excel will not be happy with this plotting in MATLAB, because they used to do all the stuff with a very, very user-friendly interface that enables you or allows you to do anything with just a click of a mouse. And what we are going to show today is that MATLAB has this interface actually that can enable you to do all these things with some clicking. And to do this, I just defined these two x and y variables, and then I will now plot x, y. Very, very basic, simple plot with no more formatting. I didn't do anything more than what we usually do. I'll just keep it here so that it's not covered with my photo here. What we need to do first is that we need to click on one button and then the magic will start. This button is here actually. It's called Show Plot Tools and Doc Figure. I think it will be here, plot edit toolbar. You can get it from here or from there anyways, but I prefer to make it here. And once you do this, it will show some options here. And now let's see what we have. So you'd see that you have your figure already here, but there's some stuff that showed here, or they're shown up here. If you don't see all this stuff, don't worry, you can get them from here. We would be more interested in the property editor, not as interested in this, but this is the main part that I'm talking about today. And what this property editor does is exactly what we used to do in Excel. Just click on whatever thing that you are interested in and all the options will show up below. So I'm now clicking on the data series, and then you can change the X and Y sources. For instance, I want it to be Y versus X. I can do this. It didn't change. Anyway, it might change later, or it's not the right place to change it. Anyways, it's not the point that I'm trying to make. Now we can change it from line to bar. You can change it to area. You can change it to stairs. Different plot types. I just make it line. You can now change the line type from solid line to dashed line. You can change it into dotted line. Anything you will need, you will find here. You can change the line thickness. I'll make it 2, for instance. I can change the color to red if I want. I can make the marker rectangle. I can make it triangle. You can make it circle. You can make the line thinner so it looks better. You see, it's way, way easier. You can change the marker size. You can really change the marker full color. It's terrible now. I would choose any other color. And you see, it's just by simply clicking, you can do any formatting you're interested in. So it's one thing that is very, very useful with the property editor. First, to change the formatting of the data series, you can do more formatting that's related to the plotting area. For instance, I need to let's say add label for x-axis. So I would say this is x, and now it is x, so I can see it here. Click on the y-axis and then change this to y, and now you can see this is y. Now you can change the text, or let's say you can first change the range from 0 to 4. I can change it and change this from 0 to let's say 55 or 60. So I change everything. You can add grid lines from here for X and for Y. You can make the scale logarithmic, not just linear, from here. Let's say you need to change the tick marks or the distance between the tick marks. So not this one. So you can click on ticks here, and then you can see that you can change the step to, let's say, 5. And then apply, and now it's 5. And for y axis, you can do the same. I can make it the step by, let's say, 0.25, and then apply. And it's pretty simple, very, very easy, straightforward, no problems. You can add more data. Let's say I would define another variable z, which is sine x. And now I can add more plots, so can write just by simply right click here and then add data. I think I can do it from here. No, not from here. I can do it from here, just right click and then add data. And from add data, you can change the type, any type that you want. Of course, I'll make it the same thing. The x data source will be x, and the y source is now z. And here it is, you can see it now. I can definitely change the scale of the y-axis so that the second plot shows up. It needs to be from negative, I would make 2. But now this is some kind of stupid thing. You need to redefine the scale. I make it first auto, and then step of 0.5, and then apply. And you can also change this scale. You have the name, this is z versus x, and you can display the name this as y versus x. And you need to change this, because if you want to add a legend, you can just click here, and the legend would include the names that you have here. So for instance, I want to change the name of this plot. I would make it second plot. It will be showing up here at the second plot. Very simple, straightforward. You can change even the color of the background. So I would make it gray, for instance, and I would make the color, background color of the figure, not the plot, to be white, so that I can put it in an Excel file, or I mean in a document that doesn't want to have all these gray colors in the background. You can even change the thickness of the axis. I don't know, where was it? Let me see. Oh yeah, it's not here, and this is a good thing that I remembered. But before we go to this, we can even change the font that you're using, and this was something that was not doable before. You have here the lists, like the same thing that you see when you go for any software. Let's say I can make it I'm choosing any random font, and you see the font is changing as you do anything here. So it's a very cool thing. You can even change the title. I can make it editor tutorial. So now it shows here, it should show up here. This is the name here, but you can change the plot or put a title for the figure itself. It's here. It's tutorial. So now the figure title is showing up here. And now we get to the point that I was just talking about. What is the more properties? And when you click on the more properties, you have a list of different things that you can see, which are included here, and other stuff that are not included. So let's see, talk about the axis and plot appearance. You would see the graphics moving. You have some kind of advanced options. The figure appearance, you can change colors of stuff. I will not spend time working on these, because I usually search for the stuff by myself. But you can see that you have options for almost everything that you might be interested in. And you can just with a click of a mouse change anything that you want pretty easily. So this is for the plotting and doing everything with the plot tools. And here comes one important question, which is why did we spend that much time working on you can do even subplots here. So let's say you need subplot, you just what you need to do instead of writing subplot 1, subplot 2 or anything, just click on this shape and choose the number of subplots that you want. It is very, very easy. You can even put 10 subplots, 2, 3, 4, whatever number of subplots you want. It's your choice. Put whatever thing you want. And this is a very, very powerful tool actually, is to do all this stuff with this very, very user-friendly interface. And now comes the question, is why did you spend that much time working on the coding before if we have that very, very useful user-friendly tool? And the answer is that because it's not always the case that you have the data ready on the command window or on the data before we're here. In the workspace, and these data are ready for plotting, and you just do the plotting without doing anything else. In many cases, you would have a program, and this program generates data, and these data will be plotted automatically without having the luxury of doing all these edits by the user interface. If you have the data, then I would definitely go for this. If I have already a data that I'm plotting, I would never do the coding. But you need to know how to do the coding, because you would find yourself in a case that, and we will see this in future videos, you write a code or a program, a very big program, and you will tell the program that you have to plot this data, and you will not have the option to do all these edits with the program doing all these plots. So you need to know both. I know it's easier to work with this, but in many cases you will have no option but just writing the code. So I know people would love this a lot, and it was actually a surprise for me to find this interface. I didn't know it but just a few months before. So I hope you like it, and I'll see you next video channel. Goodbye.